Hello, welcome back. In our last video, we discussed using the editing buttons at the bottom of the interface. Today, we're going to take a look at the text properties over here under the movie. Now, when you set your captions, they're going to take on whatever text properties you have set here. But let's say I set all my captions and I decide, well, I don't like that color for the text. I want the second caption to be yellow instead of white. So I select yellow for the text color and I do a preview and where's my yellow text? I set it to yellow. Well, what I forgot to do was to click one of these two buttons down here to either change a selected caption or captions or to change all the captions because the text property settings are only good for new captions unless I click one of these buttons. So if I select the second caption, for example, it will tell me that the font color is still set to white since I didn't click one of those buttons. So now I'll reselect yellow and click the Change Selected Caption button and it will tell me it's changed. So now when I do a preview, I see my text is now yellow. Let's just change them all to yellow now and do another preview. And we see that all the text is now yellow. Okay, so for the top row of the text properties, we need to use one of the two buttons to make the change. Not so with the background properties. Since you can only have one background throughout your caption video, there's no need to. So I can select blue as the background color, and do a preview and they're all blue. The background height setting next to it will need to be adjusted to fit your caption with the most lines of text. In this case, three lines of text fit with a 55 pixel background height, but a 45 pixel height would cut off the last line. The background height will vary with your font and style values, so you'll need to check your longest caption to be sure. You can also choose to have no background at all. This might be a bit harder to read depending on the overall shade of the movie. Still another option would be to put the captions below the movie. You can do this either in the Preferences window or under the Edit menu by choosing Change Text Track Location. Your two options there are either in the bottom portion of the movie, keeping the same aspect ratio, or below the movie, which would increase the movie's height by the number of pixels that the background height is set to. One more thing in the text properties that you'll see is the SCC row. This will come into play only if you'll be exporting as one of the SCC options. The SCC format is the type of captions you might see on TV. They allow you to put a caption on one of 15 rows, with the default at the bottom on row 15. You might want to change the row to a higher setting if there are some lower third titles on the video you don't want the captions to block, for example. We'll talk about SCC captions in another video, as they're an entirely different animal. So that's about it for this tutorial. Next time we'll talk about the proper way to import plain text files. Thanks for watching. And you can try MovieCaptioner for yourself. Download the free 14-day trial version today at www.syncromedia.com.